Thank you very much. I'm talking today about how IT enables the business by providing self-services to do analytics themselves. But first, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Bertram Pamminger, as already mentioned by the introduction. I'm from Stuttgart, Germany. I work in IT in the trucks department for 15 years, and you all hopefully have bought our cars and know our products. But the trucks and the cars are very different, and so are the employees. We truckies are proud to be more like the truck driver, whereas the passenger car colleagues are more like the S-Class driver. In the last years, we have at Daimler, we got a new CIO. The new CIO told us we should focus more on the data and the assets we have in the data. And we have started working on big data, on advanced analytics. And I myself started working on that about 3 years ago. And it's really a good time. I really enjoyed that. It's before I was a program manager, and now I have really the joy of creating insights myself. So data visualization is a very powerful tool to understand data. For example, we have 82 models at Daimler Trucks for our heavy-duty truck. And those are tractors, rigid, tippers, concrete pourers with different amount of axles and so on and so forth. So what if I would ask you, what is the model that is most likely that it will be produced on a Thursday? I've already prepared the data, did all the data engineering. This is the data. It's going to be very difficult to go through that and find the answer. Not if I use visualization. I've brought here three examples of how you can do that. Then the answer is pretty easy to find. You can either do a tree map, and tree map, the squares will tell you the volume of each model on each day. And you can see the model C964202 with 37.5% on a Thursday is the answer to our question. You also see that we produce more on a Friday than on a Monday. And other information that I didn't look for, just find them by by making it visible. Okay. Second is a line chart. I can do the line chart, same answer, of course, but I see different things here. I don't see that the production goes up each day in the week, but I see that the average is quite strongly around the 20%, which makes sense because it's coincidence-based. All the box and whiskers, that message is even stronger. I can see the deviation in the data, and I can see the outliers really clearly. So all different ways to find answer in the data. So now we've created an insight, right? Insight is a piece of information that I deduct from data. What do I do with this? What do I do with the information that on a when I order the C964202, it's most likely to be produced on a Thursday? Nothing. This is a totally pointless piece of information. So it's really important while we're creating insights that we're answering the right questions and not just creating insights for the sake of, oh, that's interesting. We need to bring the insights into the business process. We need to have decisions based on those insights, and we need to make those decisions better in order to deduct value from analytics. And we call this process-embedded analytics. So we need two things. We need data scientists, and we need to have the business experts. The data scientists bring data literacy to the table. They know how to work the data, they know how to wrangle the data. The business experts know the right questions they need answers for, and they know the business meaning of the data. And only when I bring those two together, I can work meaningfully. And how do I combine the two? There are three ways to do that. I can either have a central data science team. Oftentimes, companies set up a central data science team. The advantage is, of course, it's an easy to manage team. The experts talk to each other. They stay up to date in their subject. The problem here is they are kind of detached from the business, and they don't really know what really the questions are that people need answers for. So the second approach is I bring those data scientists into the business departments. The problem here is I need a lot of resources to do that. Of course, the advantage is that I have the people who know how to wrangle the data work closely with the people that know the questions, and they will get the right answers, or the answers to the right questions. But still, the resource factor is a huge problem. So I could try to provide analytics as a self-service. And if I compare that to the other options, the people who work in the business process, they know best what answers they're looking for. They know best what needs to be analyzed. And there is no additional resources I need because the people who are already working in the business process doing the analytics as well, the only thing they need is data literacy, and I can teach them that. They already know the business meaning of the data. I can teach them the relation of the data and so on and so forth. That's easy to achieve. So when we say data science as a, or data analytics as a self-service, it is being able to generate insights while you are working in your daily work, while you're working in the business process. So that is the answer, right? But are we really there yet? This is my favorite tool, Tableau. I'm not sponsored, it's just my opinion. Can I give this to the business? I would say no. This is clearly a tool that needs to be, that needs to have an educated user and not something I can just deploy. I have 2,700 users. If I give them that and they call me about how do I do this formula, then I'm very busy. So I don't want to do that. Why are all the tools complex? So this is an easy tool. Everybody knows how to use that, but these are the problems we have. Yeah, though not every problem is the same, and the tools need to be able to handle all kinds of problems to be a good analytics tools. So what we really need as a tool is something like that. And that is complex, and that is just in the nature of things. And the industry has driven making those tools better and easier to use to a huge extent already, but it's still an expert's tool. So this is how I see the world. Standard questions can be answered pretty easily. Today I can buy a software I can talk to and put the data in, and the tool will sort the data by itself, and I will just talk to the computer and say, show me the profits for quarter 3 and quarter 4 combined, and the tool will do that. But that's a very standard question, and that's the reason why it works, because it's a standard question, and the industry who provides those tools can prepare for that. The more specific the question gets, the more I need to work with the tool and the more skills I need to bring to the table myself in order to be able to answer the question, up to the extent where I need data science. Let's take a step back and look at the truck industry really quick so you understand better where I'm coming from. We are a high variant mass product, and that is a combination you don't have often. Usually you have either high variant, like a power plant, or you have a mass product, like an iPhone. And actually, I'm reusing this slide a lot. I did this slide 2017, and I went to apple.com and I counted how many iPhones are there. And there was the iPhone 6S, the 7, iPhone SE, and I counted memory, and I counted even color, and I came to 52 variants. That's all they have, 52 variants. So if you look at our colleagues in the car sector, of course, they have a lot more. There's a Swedish pop-up on my screen. Is my slide too complicated? Okay, so if you look at the passenger cars, and if you have ever bought a Mercedes or configured a Mercedes, then you know there's a lot of options you can choose from. And the combination of those options bring the variance into the hundreds of millions you have. If you haven't done that, please, after this session, find a computer, go to mercedes-benz.com and do so. If you look at the trucks, so a car always has two axles. The car usually has a fixed wheelbase. Sometimes we have a long version, then it's two wheelbases. And there's a big fuel tank and a small fuel tank, or the standard fuel tank. For the trucks, you can have either two, three, four, even five axles. We have 72 configurations for the fuel tank. We have a lot of cabins that we can put on the truck. We had somebody at Daimler who was trying to get the right number for how many variants we have in the truck section. And he gave up and said, it's not possible. It's theoretically infinite. So we wait until this is done and all the infinite amount of trucks has been shown. No, I'm running out of time, so I'll move on. But this is our challenge. This is why we have complex data, because our product is complex. So self-service, as we see it in Daimler Trucks, answers to specific questions, not only the standard ones, not only give me profit of whatever, on very complex data. I should not make my user search for the right information in the data. And whatever he does, he needs to be able to communicate with the tool in his language. So I need to have an intuitive interface. In other words, I need to serve insights on a silver platter. Again, I have 2,700 users I need to deploy my solutions to. So let's take one example, correlation analysis. So I made up this data. Radio and speaker usually don't buy separately, but let's say you would. We have radios 1 through 4, and we have speakers A through D. So we can see from this the radio 4 and speaker D is the most popular options, but we can also see that D3 is the most popular combination, and you can see that A1 is actually a very popular combination, even though neither 1 nor A is a top runner. That's an insightful chart to the business, especially if you're designing speakers and radios. So how do we get to that? Usually we have a business guy, he identifies a question and says, like, what is correlation of all speaker and radio variants? Then he comes to me, or he has a super user in his team who then will go into a visualization tool and do the program. I don't want to call it programming, but the configuration of the tool takes about 15 minutes. It's really quick. But you need to have the super user, and it's very repetitive. And then the super user says, here you go, here's your chart, and then he can work with the chart and analyze the data, because the business guy is not interested in how to create the chart. He wants this information on the chart. So radio and speaker, but there's other questions as well that I can ask. I can ask engine and emission level. I can ask axle and tires. I can ask transmission and power takeoffs. I can ask all kinds of questions. We have, in a standard truck, we have 300 options that need to be selected. Again, high variant. So a lot of options are available, and a lot of decisions have to be made when you buy a truck. Just for two options, you have 45,000 options to combine two codes, and that's only two codes. So what we need to find here is we need to find the generic question. In this case, it is correlation of any two options. And once we have the generic question, we can then go on and solve this problem once for every instance of the problem. So basically what we do is we create a tool that can handle the dashboard creation. So we have identified the question already, correlation of all radio and speaker variants. Now comes my tool. I have two input fields, radio and speaker, and I have the output of a dashboard that I want. You can see the business guy, the IT guy is gone from this process. It's only 15 minutes, but it's repetitive, and I don't want to do a 15-minute task multiple times. How do we do that? So basically, our tool has an input interface, and the important thing is here, it needs to work with natural language, and For our engineers, Boolean algebra is also a natural language. Sounds weird, is so. Then the tool will translate the user input into, in our case, Tableau XML. It will put the created Tableau code into a dashboard, that we, dashboard template that we created, and then upload it to the Tableau server. And the user can then get his dashboard from the Tableau server without needing to have an IT guy, needing to touch any code, nothing. Of course, this is not only possible for the chart with correlation of two codes. You can do a Pareto chart. You can, yeah, you can do a more complex chart like this one. You can do bar charts. You can do tile charts. Whatever. You just need to find the right generic question. You define the template together with the business, and then you implement it into the process, and then you provide a self-service solution. Again, the front work is important, to sit down together with the business, to understand the intent, to understand, one, this is a question that comes up all the time. I want to know the correlation between two codes in our example. You define the methodology, you have a proof of concept, and you define the template. And they, okay, if I give you this as the answer, will this work for you? And so yes, you move on. You implement it into the tool, and then the business can do self-service as often as they want with no effort for you anymore on all 45,000 possible questions. So, from our perspective, the four steps to a successful self-service. First, you need to have data under your control. If you know your data, if you manage your data well, you achieve data governance. Then you need to have the right tools. If you have your tools, you achieve data visualization. You need to have your methods in form of code, that's algorithms. If you have that, you have advanced analytics. But as a top layer, you need automation. And once you have automation on top of all of that, then you have embedded analytics. And if you look at our chart from before, what we do when we deploy that is we bring the curve down by automation. We extend the field where self-service is possible without a skill level that you really need. So you can't answer all the questions. You can't deploy a self-service tool that works this way for any problem that is out there, but for any problem that is predefined and has a generic way of solving it that you know already. So you will always have the room where you need data scientists, and there's two scientists in the slide. I'll correct this later. But that becomes smaller. You can have those people focus on the really complex problems, and for the rest you automate and you deploy for the business to use it as a true self-service. So what I'm saying here is you should think about investing into the few, into the IT teams who can do that to enable the many. You have a small IT team who does that, they deploy to hundreds and hundreds of users, you have invested your money really well. Thank you very much.